On the Medical Watch this afternoon, measles and spring break travel. Measles was considered eliminated from the U.S. in 2000, but a handful of cases have popped up in recent years, including some in Florida in the past few weeks, where state health officials have not encouraged vaccination or isolation for those at risk. Dr. Nick Cozy is an emergency physician at Rush University Medical Center and has recently co-authored a study for emergency medicine doctors on measles. Good to have you back.
Good to see you, Ben.
First, give us some perspective. We're at, I think, 10 reported cases in Florida. Is that unusual or cause for alarm?
Well, you have to remember, Ben, it's a great question, right? Where is measles at right now? Measles was eliminated in the United States in 2000. So 11 cases is concerning, and especially concerning as we get around the spring break travel period for Chicagoans thinking of going down to the state of Florida.
So how does measles transmit?
Measles gets transmitted airborne. It's actually more infectious and more contagious than COVID. It sticks around in the environment for up to 2 days, but incredibly serious for those who are non-vaccinated for measles.
And what's the difference in risk for vaccinated versus unvaccinated people?
We're talking less than 4%. So 4 people in 100 who are vaccinated for measles will get measles, but you have roughly over a 95% chance if you're unvaccinated for measles of actually contracting a very contagious disease. And we've seen more and more folks who are not vaccinating their children, as well as the global migration patterns are also playing into account for this.
And if you're unvaccinated and get the measles, I read your hospitalization chances and chances for the most dangerous of outcomes go through the roof.
It's a great question, right? Unvaccinated folks who get measles, the hospitalization rates rise. You're more likely to have brain infections called encephalitis. You're more likely to have pneumonia, more likely to have severe disease. And prevention is what we are promoting here, not only in the city, but nationally as emergency physicians.
And we have not seen measles here in Illinois, but as you point out, spring break travel moves people around. And so one of the points, I think, of this paper that you co-authored was, hey, if you work in an ER, you should be alert to some of the signs of measles. And you say they can vary, meaning this can look different in people with different skin tones.
I think that's the biggest point we want to communicate, is that measles looks different depending on your skin tone. So for those who have darker skin, whether you're Latino, African-American, those who are Asian, it looks different than it does in the Caucasian population. And for emergency providers around the country, we have to be on guard for this type of presentation, because there are so many children who present to ERs with fever as well as rash. And the more onus is on us to be able to recognize. But I will say there was a case in Northwest Indiana, folks who were coming through Chicago. So we have seen one in Illinois as of last week.
Oh, interesting. I had not heard about that. And you said, you know, for all the attention that COVID got, measles transmits far more quickly among the unvaccinated. How does that work? I mean, does it have to be contact among spittle or bodily fluid, or is it airborne?
It's airborne. Measles is an airborne disease. It's something that, you know, we vaccinate children, whether they're 12 months or 15 months, and then they get one more immunization before 6 years of age, and it's incredibly protective. And we find more and more that those who are unvaccinated are being responsible for the rapid rise in measles across the country and across the world.
We think of a measles shot for kids, but if you are an adult and for whatever reason never got one, can you still get that vaccination?
Absolutely. Mm. Those who are unvaccinated as adults can choose to get that immunization. We recommend it. We don't recommend it for those who are pregnant because it can have complications for those who are pregnant. So we recommend talking to your healthcare provider whether it's right for you. But for 95% of the population, it will be right for you.
Dr. Nick Cozy from Rush, we always appreciate your perspective and you joining us. Thank you.
Thank you, Ben. Have a great day.
You too.